Good morning, everybody, and thank you, Dr. Grover, sir, and Dr. Ramesh, for inviting me for this talk. In 7 minutes, I don't know how much justice I can do to this topic. I'll just brush through on what all really you need to know. Remember that whenever you order a test, you should know really what you are subjecting a patient to. A CT scan is going to subject your patient to radiations. An MRI, though it sounds flashy and nice, but once you undergo an MRI orbit yourself, you know how claustrophobic it is to get a MRI done. So just think over before you order things. Ultrasound, by and large, it helps in making your diagnosis, but many of the cases, just ultrasound is not going to help, but definitely it corroborates with the histological structure. So if you have a, confusion, you can always go, or you have a, recurrent, you want to examine and again, it's an OPT procedure, you just put your probe and just check what's happening. But otherwise, most of the times, you would require a CT or an MRI for your management. Now, this I'll not go into details because there's no time. Just remember that when we are doing CT, we are working with X-rays. When we are talking about MRI, we are basically making use of these hydrogen nuclei, which are normally, producing, moving randomly, and we are applying a magnetic field. They get aligned. We put a radio frequency wave and then switch it off and measure the T1 and T2. Now, in bone, we don't have so many hydrogen atoms, so that is the reason the bone is not going to be picked up with an MRI scan. So whenever you want to see any relationship with your, the tissues and or any bony erosions, then the first choice would be a CT scan instead of an MRI. Whenever you want to look for, tumors or anything which have a lot of vascular supply or maybe the orbital apex, you go for an MRI scan. So without going into too many details, I'll just, one more thing, T1 is the anatomical scan, and in fact, it is much better to see the boundaries with T1 weighted images. And if there is any confusion, which one is T1 and T2, just look at the color of the vitreous. So that's a very good way to pick it up. Fluids are very dark with T1 weighted image. This is, of course, a very, gross way of picking things. There are a lot of intricate details. If the fluid is moving at a high speed, it creates a fluid void. So there are so many things, intricate details you need to know. There are a lot of images like stair images and flare images. What does it mean? Stair means fat suppression. When you're doing a T1 or T2 weighted image, otherwise the fat appears hyper intense. But if you want to see something which is, it may be something in the muscle itself, and if you have a lot of white thing next to it and you are not able to identify it separately, then you order for a fat suppression image. Then the stair images, these are used for, when you have to see these plaques, here you can see these multiple sclerosis plaques in the brain, then you order for flare images. Now, again, I'll just jump onto the diseases. If you have a patient with trauma, so what would you order? Again, classically, when we were being taught, we were told to get X-rays done, but nowadays, I think X-rays is just a preliminary test. You really don't get to identify everything. It's just for the screening. Actually, a good CT scan would be of more use, but before you order a CT scan, again, there are certain contraindications which you need to keep in mind. And also, sometimes the patient may be having multiple structures getting involved. So just an orbital CT may not suffice. So just be very careful what you order, because you're going to subject the patient to radiation again and again. So you may require a CT orbit, PNS, and head in multiple polytrauma cases. Just remember that. And have a look, you can very clearly see, it's so easy to see that this is an orbital fracture flow. So you can see the teardrop sign. So these are very easy to see. You can pick up the emphysema, if there is a medial wall fracture. Also, if there is a foreign body lying there, 0.5 millimeter of a metallic foreign body can be picked up by a CT scan. Whereas if it's a plastic or a wood foreign body, maybe a larger size would be picked up. Now, foreign bodies can also be picked up. Suppose you don't have an access to CT scan, and it's a closed globe injury. You can always get an X-ray done, and then you can do your ultrasound and have a, just see all around and have a look. But if you want to see the relation, exact relation, you want to remove this foreign body and you know, want to see the structures adjacent to it, a CT scan gives a much, much better idea. Now, MRI per se is not required in every trauma case. However, if you want to stage the orbital hematoma, especially in medico-legal cases, there an MRI is far more useful. Now, look at these images. This patient came to our emergency. The residents, they ordered the x-rays. We saw this foreign body. There was something lying here. Then we went ahead and got a CT scan done, and you see there are so many things happening which had been missed in a x-ray. So there are so many foreign bodies here and there, multiple fractures. So you see the amount of information that can be obtained by getting a CT scan done versus just an MRI, just an x-ray. Again, this is an x-ray done for this patient. Nothing much picked out. We did go ahead and did an ultrasound. Nothing much picked up, and here we got a CT scan done and there is a foreign body. So you see, if the foreign body is lying just adjacent to the quartz, it can again be missed by an ultrasound. So this is another point to be taken. If you have patients, I have a lot of lacrimal patients coming in for DCR and medial canthal reconstruction. So here you need 3D CT images so that you know what exactly you're dealing with, what kind of, I think Dr. Ramesh was talking about whether you would be needing a burr or something, because all these bones, after they get fractured, they get malaligned, and you need to really, it's not just simple that blunt and sharp curette that's going to break this bone. So you need something, a mechanized drill or something is required to create an opening, and also to check whether your nasal cavity is roomy enough for creating a opening here. So again, this is a very helpful. This is a patient who came with this foreign body. We did not know what was there. Somebody treated her for cysticercosis. She kept on. In between, she'll become all right. We got a CT scan done. I realized there's some kind of foreign body sitting here. I removed it. It was a feather. There was a keratin kind of the feather of a bird. So again, a CT scan is extremely useful. This is a patient who came with traumatic keratico-cavernous fistula. Of course, we can make a clinical diagnosis also, but to supplement, you see these enlarged muscles. Okay, and this fluid spaces. So now enlarged muscles, you can see there is generalized enlargement and there is generalized congestion everywhere, and this was going in favor of CCF. The muscles can also be enlarged in myositis, and in myositis what will happen is that the tendons here, they will be enlarged, whereas they can also be enlarged in a thyroid ophthalmopathy where the belly can be enlarged. But this kind of a picture where there is a generalized enlargement, also keep in mind, in thyroid enlargement, it will be the inferior rectus and the medial rectus would be enlarged. It will not be in a generalized enlargement like this. So these things can be picked up. Dermoid, of course, you want to see a bony erosion is there or not. You have a dumbbell dermoid or not. Again, you will order a CT, not an MRI. And for infectious processes, for time up, cysticercosis again. This is another interesting patient. Patient had recurrent ptosis, and she was treated for so many things. So much antibiotics have been infused. We just got a CT done, and we picked up a scolus sitting right in the superior rectus. So just always rule out cysticercosis. The patient was given. I'll just skip all the slides. Just one point I want to convey is that in patients with retinoblastoma, please be very careful when you order a CT scan, because these exposure to radiation can lead to lateral or secondary malignancies. There is no end to these pictures. In that case, you must go for a clinical examination. You must go for an ultrasonography, and it may be supplemented by an MRI. Please don't get a CT scan done. Other lesions like lacrimal tumors and all that, if it's an adenocarcinoma, like in this patient, just show you this, the reference. You have to see for the bony erosion. You have a young patient coming like this. There is a mass setting here. You must get a CT scan done, not an MRI, because you want to see the relationship of this tumor with the bone. So again, you have to choose which particular procedure to use. And of course, if there is a confusion between a meningioma and optic nerve glioma, there was another patient where you can see these calcium deposits, which are very characteristics of a meningioma. So for these, again, you would order a CT scan. These may be missed in an MRI. Of course, there will be hyperintensity, but these are better clearly seen in a CT scan. So I'll just conclude because my time is up. Another, just one more point, sir. This AV malformations and vascular anomalies, here you have to be very careful. You have to be very systematic, a very good clinical examination in the sense that you must do a Valsalva, you must see the pulsations. You must try to differentiate whether it's a high flow or a low flow. And after that, you get a Doppler done to see this was a patient where we got a Doppler done, and you can pick up these high flow channels here. So you have to differentiate whether you are going to act or you have to send the patient for interventional radiology for embolization and ligation. Of course, cavernous hemangioma you can pick up with anything. Lymphangioma is one condition where you see you with ultrasound, you even if with MRI you pick up you know, these generalized cystic, large cystic spaces. With ultrasound, it really supplements because you can pick up these spaces and you know that this what kind of management you're going for. If you want to just aspirate and inject the sclerosing agent, large cystic spaces are very is a patient with in which you're going to apply this kind of management. So again, it supplements, and I think I'll just end because
I think
the next session
we now know that you need a 1 hour talk. It's a wonderful collection.
Anyway, thank you so much. So you can all come and talk to me outside if you want to ask. I don't know really, sir, how to end because the conclusion itself is going to take some time. Only thing is the contrast enhanced. Whenever you're looking for vascular tumors, you may go in for a contrast enhanced CT scan. And of course, again, to summarize, the orbital apex, you want to visualize properly, you must go for an MRI. And be careful what you order. Multiple exposures are going to lead to radiation, so be very careful. In MRI, of course, the pacemakers and or metallic clips these have to be ruled out before you subject a patient to MRI because these are contraindications. Thank you.